Hi everyone. This video is more of an opinion piece. I want to share this opinion with you so that I can get your thoughts and your feedback. Hopefully by the end of it, we'll understand each other. And through this discussion, this community, we'll be able to come up with a solution which makes sense to all of us. My observation in the last few years is that software interviews are broken. They don't do what they intend to do, and they are much harder than they should be. I'll just give you some statistics, right? The average preparation time for software interviewers is 3 months. 3 months is a quarter of a year, which means that if you're starting to prepare now in October, you will be giving interviews in January. And that's a lot of time, especially if you're in a senior position. You know, you have wife, you have kids, you have a lot of work pressure, and then you have 3 months that you have to prepare on totally irrelevant job interview questions. So the process is really, really long. And on the other side, for companies, the problem is they want people with job relevant skills. They want to test you on your workplace capabilities. But what happens is for every open position, they have hundreds of applicants, hundreds of people who send their resumes. Even if you have an ATS parser, you have a large number of candidates who pass this resume filter test. What we do test people on is time complexity, which, I mean, as an engineer, you rarely come across data structures and algorithms problems at work. Yes, if you know it, it's good, but that doesn't mean that you need to know this to get a normal job. Okay. For startups, mid-sized companies, many, many positions in large companies, these skills being tested by LeetCode right now and HackerRank are totally irrelevant. Absolutely irrelevant. I'm telling you, as a computer programmer, there are people who leave their job because what you test them on is not relevant to the job. They are bored because they like math and you ask them engineering. They don't care. They're going to leave. They want research. Okay. That's what I have experienced as a computer programmer. And also training us is so much harder. You know, we know nothing about development. So we are here in the job and now you start teaching us Spring and everything else. We don't know anything about frameworks. We don't know anything about UI. We like coding. We like writing binary search. So spend the next 3 months now training us. So that's the problem right now. And I'll tell you why this is the problem. I mean, before we look at the future, we just need to look a little bit in the past to see what's going on. 2002 to 2012, tech hiring usually used to be around MCQs. Okay. You would be asked questions on a programming language, like what does this keyword do? Or if you write this code, then what will happen? Talk about exception handling, talk about what volatile means in Java, right? So this was more knowledge based. There's nothing that was being tested. You were not asked to demonstrate your skills. In 2013, things changed. What came in was the idea that you could remotely execute a candidate's code at very cheap rates. So a candidate can come in, write some code, and you can test this on your server to check if the code actually runs. You could also set time limits to see whether the code is efficient. So problem solving is something that you could check out really efficiently. This was also the time when a lot of competent programmers started doing really well because they were practiced with remote code executors and they could solve problems efficiently and give answers. So competent programming became a way to get jobs, which is funny, right? But this is what happened. The tool which came out was an automated tester. You could scale hiring using this in software engineering. Now in 2024, this method is broken. There is little to no relevance that computer programming has to your daily work. And when you're talking about LeetCode problems, medium hard, it's more of a joke. You can also ask people, you know, how many petrol pumps exist in your city, right? It's an estimation question. It's an IQ question. It is objective, but it has no relevance to your job. It has nothing to do with your workplace capabilities. So what can we do? How do we hire the right candidates? And this is where we need a tester, which is automated so that it can scale and it has like zero bias, which tests candidates on their engineering skills, like making sure that systems don't collapse, like making sure that concurrency is both implemented and managed. So make the engineers think like people who are writing API contracts, implement those API contracts, and then bring in real world engineering problems to the tools that they're writing. Okay, this is the next generation of software interviewing. And so instead of a coding round, it's going to be a software round now. And at the startup I work, InterviewReady, we have two tools which are going to be testing you on your engineering skills. And the way it does it is by asking you to write code. You write code and the code has to be fault tolerant. If things fail, if the system that you're connecting to did not give a response or it was too slow, you have to do something about it. You either have to give a retry or you have to propagate the error back. Okay, so we'll be testing you on that. There's another type of thing. If the system is a little slow, then shouldn't you apply some sort of concurrency here? Shouldn't you utilize your resources, your network to the maximum? So we are going to be looking at your asynchronous programming also. The second thing is a system design judge. The first version of the system design judge is already available at InterviewReady. You can try it out now. I'll have a link in the description. By completing this design, you know exactly what each component means. So that is the definition. You understand what the meaning of a component is. And the second thing is you know where to apply a component. So if you see something missing and you add a cache to it and you see it's correct, then you not only know what a cache is, but you also know where a cache is applied. The future versions of this tool are going to be even more advanced. And the launch date for this is 21st November. I hope to be able to get your feedback quickly. So, we'll probably start with a beta program and you can share your feedback with us and then we'll go back and forth and back and forth. There's a lot of people in India and abroad who are not able to crack interviews because the interviews are totally irrelevant to their job, you know? And in fact, they don't even find a place where they can train themselves better for their job. They don't have mentors. There's a accent problem. There's a language problem. If you build tools, which is going to test them on their job relevant skills, then they can train themselves. They can self-practice with this kind of a judge. And for companies also, it's great because if you're doing things which are relevant to your job and because of that, you get the next job, they save on costs. So I've already spoken to people from the Indian Mobile Congress, a Google Startup School, from more than 50 companies right now. And most of them are super excited about it, but I take it with a pinch of salt because being super excited and actually signing a contract are very different things. But I've had lots of people from various companies, including Fang, approach and say that this is something that we absolutely need. Show us a demo ASAP. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the comments.